Alright, what is going on, guys? Today we are watching Haikyuu Season 4 to the top, Episode 4. I've been waiting all day for this. I think it was supposed to come out at 7:30. I don't actually know if it came out then. Because usually I wait for the downloadable version of it. Just so it's better quality and nothing screws up. Does my hat look bent? I can't tell. And, you know, everything looks squeaky clean and it's easier to record. But it's still not out, so I've decided to just watch it on Crunchyroll. Excited for this episode. We were going to see like the true progression. I think it was last week, wasn't it? Where Suki was said to Hinata, like, come with me, he's going to help him in some way. So, I kind of do need the little refresh every week for Haikyuu, just so I can remember what was happening. Because it's very early on in the season and not a lot happening yet. So, yeah. Anyway, guys, let's get right into the episode. Oh. He's like, oh, what are you going to do with me? He's going to kill me. Ah. He's going to help him out. What a lad. Suki. Oh. You know when you're like singing to yourself and you think, oh yeah, there's music playing over this, so it sounds better in my head, and then you realize I don't record any sound from the anime in my videos, so it's just me singing like a drowned cat. So about this episode, I mean I don't really have much to say this week, really, because, you know, we've been kind of working towards this moment of the last two episodes of where Hinata was in a rut and then he's working to get out of it. He needs to learn something, you know, something's on his mind. He has a plan. Well, someone else has a plan for him, like Suki, for example. So I'm excited to see what he's going to do, see what he's going to discover about himself, what he's going to learn, what he's going to focus on when it comes to practice, and what he can do, because he's only a ball boy. But yeah, exciting times. I can't remember from the preview, but I think we'll get to see a bit of Kageyama action this week, more so than last week anyway, when he just missed the set. Yeah. See Orion's the episode. I'm excited. Oh, we're at the National Training Center, so Kageyama. Ooh. That's a banging meal. Is that regular meals? Oh. Thinking you look like a broccoli, apparently. Yeah, bruh. Damn, bro, can't relate. That's the look on his face. Ooh. To combined teamwork of Gerstner. Yeah, and he's about. Well, yeah, like. Hinata and Suki. Yeah. You know, still stopped him. What does this hoodlum want? Kageyama is like not fazed by this. I like Kageyama's confidence in this situation. He doesn't really care. Hudo. Yeah, he seems like the type. I feel like I've looked this up before, but who's Kageyama's voice actor? He has a very distinctive voice that I recognize. He looks like a freak. Like, not in a bad way, like crazy volleyball master. Oh, Japanese food and anime looks so good. God's sake. Oh, God's sake. Ham katsu. I can still hear the music to this scene. Amazing, amazing season. Yeah, what was his reaction on his face? Raw oysters. Never tried oysters. Don't know if I could eat them raw, like, or, unless they're better raw, I don't know. But isn't raw, like, basically just them straight out the ocean, or are they treated in some way? I don't know. Oh, sorry, Kyle. He probably appreciates that. Can have three tall dudes against Hinata. They really like. They know his worth. Oh, were they not against Hinata? I don't know. Whoa, what was that? Oh, really? Oh, damn, he's like 6'1", isn't That was interesting. Like I said last week, little things in the show that you just like never really notice. Yeah, like everybody, if they go for spikes, they usually go straight forward. Doing the twist that he did. So many interesting little intricate things that I don't usually take into account. He's a first year too, right? I love all the characters in the show. They're all just so interesting in their own way. Chigo. Sosuke. His face then. I should make that the thumbnail. Oh God, I'm tired. Oh yeah, it was this dude I saw in the preview. I feel like he's gonna have some beef with Kagama. What's the benefit of standing close or far away from the net? I don't know. Nice kill. Yeah. Compact and zippy. Compact and zippy. Does that make sense? Yeah, he does seem a bit awkward and stiff. Yeah, it's true. I kind of like the guy, the look of this guy, and yet I feel like he's a bitch. I can't tell. But then there's not really any characters in this show you hate, so I assume he's not that bad. Yeah, this freak. I want to see what his ability is. He's going to jump over the fucking net. Whoa. Hinata's got nothing on him. He's short like Hinata too. What a freak. Oh my god. Looks like an owl. And there's quite a few characters on the show that I think look like owls actually. Got muscly legs, jeez. What? That's a recognizable voice as well. I can't tell who though. That's a really recognizable voice. Is this supposed to sound like Hinata's? Does it sound like Hinata's, or am I just making this up? Huh? What does that mean? Boom. Dum. Do 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 dum. Do 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 do. Oh god, that killed me. Whoa, determined. Right there, you blind bastard. How do you play volleyball and be that blind? Yeah. You must have to have really good vision. I say that, and Suki's wearing glasses, but it helps to be able to have really good vision playing volleyball. As long as he's putting his all into everything, anything he's doing, even if it's not on the court, is considered training. Even if it's just general exercise, it's still training. At least he's not doing nothing. Like, run up those stairs and count as training. Gosh, I'm tired today. Jeez. Ugh. This is least favorite phrase number two. I wonder what his number one is. Okay. True, but it's also another way of playing the game. While he's taking it easy in the first half where everybody's using up their energy, when they're tired in the second half, he has the energy to deal with them. So it's not a bad situation, but people might not like it if they're on the same team. They don't understand it. Damn. What the fuck? I mean, probably understandable, but damn, poor dude. That was a very low energy over the net. He doesn't really exert himself, that's pretty cool. Yeah. Wrong. Oh, he knows. He knows. Oh. Oh, come on, someone help him. You've been invited for a reason, bro. You're good at the game. Where did this sad backstory come from? Come on, Haikyuu. Don't make me like every character. Thank you. Yeah. It's true. Don't disrespect your height. Yeah. Hey, that's what I'm doing, huh? Yeah, it's probably good being a sport, good sport. Good job, Hinata. Everybody's pissed, like, argh, this fucking kid. That fucking coach better let him play. I swear to God. He's been a good sportsman and he's helping people. What is he? I think I know what he's taught him, or what he's told him to do, but... I get it. Yeah, just delay the pass so that you and the other guy has more time to think about your next move. Now you're 2 meters tall and you can slam that on Kunibi. And there you go, bro. Yeah, let him in the game. Let Hinata in the game. He's a good coach. Exactly. And now he's stressed. Give him a high five. He deserves it. Yes! Making new bro friends. Let's go. He's still staring. They're both staring. Oh. Oh, yeah. The blonde guy was like, I don't like that guy. And now he's observing him to watch him play. Hinata's just like two birds with one stone. Hinata just helped out. That's a really cool picture right there. And it's the last thing of the episode. Such bangers in this. So, not going to talk much right now. I'm going to skip to the end like we usually do. Don't think there's going to be much though, but we'll have a look. So, one moment. Skedet, oh, queen. She's such a queen. Okay. So, that was episode 4. I've noticed in, like, the last 5 minutes... My fucking hat. Not my hat. There's been, like, a kind of delay on the stream. I really hope there is no delay, and it's just... A lot of RAM being used up or something. I don't know. But if there's delay, if there's like a little delay, there's nothing I can do. It's just annoying. But yeah. So it's probably to do with me watching on Crunchyroll, actually. This is why I prefer downloading. But yeah, anyway. So yeah. What a great episode. What I thought was going to be Hinata. The episode being based on Hinata and a bit of Kageyama. Was actually very wholesome and showed Hinata's qualities to make other people feel good, and his qualities as a coach, and maybe he'll be a coach one day. I've never really considered that. Like, you know, this guy, the old guy who won't let him play, the short guy who grows old and becomes a great coach. Who knows? Maybe that's what the little giant did or is doing. I don't know. I know nothing about the manga, but very nice episode. I enjoyed it thoroughly, and I really appreciate what Hinata did for not only the tall guy, but for the blonde guy as well, and Kunimi. It was really nice to see. And even though he did not directly learn something new, I don't think, Hinata has gotten a lot out of this. Whether he knows it or not, he's going to learn stuff. So, all in all, it's a really nice episode. And, like, good 9 out of 10 episode, I think. But yeah, I'm just staring at like the last frame in the episode was them with just being served clams. I'm like, kind of hungry for some fish food, some seafood. But yeah, anyway, guys, I'm rambling a bit now. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I certainly did, if you didn't already notice. Thank you guys so much for watching this along with me. I really appreciate it. Have a nice rest of your day, afternoon or night, morning, night for me. And I will see you guys next week. Peace.